Hey everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to connect Gemini CLI with MCP server. So I'll be showing you this entire process by connecting it with the Blender MCP. So let's get started. For this, first just Google Gemini CLI MCP, and if you scroll down we'll be having the Gemini CLI link from Google Cloud. Just open it, and here if you scroll down we'll be having model context protocol. Click it. And here they would have given you a sample procedure how to connect with GitHub MCP, so you can just check it out. And for this we just need to like add this settings.json file and put this particular piece of code inside it. So in case if you're having some other MCP server, you need to just create this particular folder structure and just add your MCP config JSON inside it. Alright, so now let's see how we can do this with Blender MCP. So first thing, I assume you have Gemini CLI configured on your system. If you don't have that, you can just click on the card that is appearing on top. Done a complete tutorial on how to use Gemini CLI. Now just go to your desired folder, right click and create a new folder. Let me just name it as Gem MCP, like this, and just open this folder in Visual Studio Code or any other editor of your choice. Once you're done opening, click on trust. And as it clearly says here, we need to create a .gemini and settings.json file. So I'll just go here and you need to create a new folder named .gemini. And inside that, a file named settings.json. And here you need to paste your MCP server code. So in my case, I'm going to use Blender MCP. So I'll just go here, the GitHub page of that. And if I scroll down, here I'm having the Blender MCP settings, so I can just copy this and put it over here. And in case if you have any other thing like GitHub or other stuff, you can just like put that MCP code over here. And apart from that, we must also install this UV package. So for that I will just go to my command prompt and copy this. So this is specific for Blender, not for other MCP servers and stuff. So I will run this. So once it is installed, we must add this path. So I will just add this, and now if I run the command UV, I shouldn't be getting any errors. Yeah, I'm just getting this. So now we are good. I've just closed it, and we have to install this particular addon.py. So can just download this file now. Yeah, that got downloaded. Next, just open Blender, and now just go to Edit, Preferences, Install, and select the file that you have downloaded. Install addon. And make sure that you are enabling this. Just enable this. Now just press the N key here and we'll be having the Blender MCP. So before starting the MCP server, you can check these, and this one is paid, so I don't have the API key, so I will uncheck. And this one is also having a API key, so I will uncheck this also. So if you have that, you can just like check these, because if you have the API keys, it can get the models from there. So after checking the necessary things, you can just select connect to MCP server. Now we need to start our Gemini CLI. So for this, we just need to go to the project where we have .gemini folder, okay? So in my case, it is present in this particular folder, and inside that I'm having .gemini and settings. So go here and type cmd and type Gemini. This will start the Gemini CLI. And as you can see, it has detected our MCP, saying using one MCP server. Now I will just go here and type /MCP and hit enter. So it's now currently in the Blender MCP, and these are the stuff that it can use, the tools to create 3D model over here. I'll just go and give a simple prompt, create me 10 trees, that's it, and hit enter. So we got a couple of errors like in between connecting with the model, like that library and stuff. But at the end, it just asked me if you want to create it like in a simple way, and I said yes, and it has created me 10 trees for me. So if I go to my Blender, and as you can see, it has done the job, not like super great, but it just does the job. The MCP server has done it automatically, and you can just use it based upon your use case, connecting to some other MCP, like adding it over here. So that's basically it, guys. I hope you have found it useful. Do check the playlist of my channel, a lot of videos in programming and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.